Good afternoon. I wanted to provide you a real-time update of where we are with the coronavirus. As of 3 p.m. today, there are 65 known cases of COVID-19 in Oregon. Cases are starting to rise, but our state and county health agencies are taking swift and decisive action to help prevent the spread of the virus. When too many cases occur in a short time frame, our health system can become overwhelmed, which makes it harder for people to get the treatment that they need. I say this not to create panic, but I do want to acknowledge the seriousness of this issue. We can all do our part to slow the spread. Four things you can do. One, wash your hands often. Two, avoid close contact with others. Avoid public places except for essential activities such as grocery shopping or doctor's appointments. Three, stay home when you're sick. Four, cover your coughs and your sneezes. Listen, I know people are scared and worried. I know you're worried about your health, your kids, your partners, your parents, and on top of that, many of you are worried about your jobs. These are the moments in history that matter. How we show up for each other in the days and weeks to come will define our community as strong, resilient, and kind. Now is the time to unite with one goal, keeping ourselves and our neighbors safe by slowing the spread of this virus. There is light at the end of the tunnel. We're now seeing communities across the globe start to begin the road to recovery as the containment of the virus happens. The first clinical trial of a COVID-19 vaccine has begun. At some point, schools will resume. You can hug your neighbors, and you're going to go to the grocery store as a mundane errand as it once was. But before we get to the end of that tunnel, we have got to stay focused on our goal, slowing the spread of this virus. Today, we're launching a one-stop resource for Gresham residents at greshamoregon.gov/COVID-19. This will link you to Multnomah County and the public health experts who can provide guidance if you are sick or if you have other health-related questions. We'll also have resources for those in need of food, how to avoid scams, and more. One resource I want to highlight are tips for how to talk about this crisis with your children. Like many of you, I am a parent who wants to make sure that my kids are heard and supported. The CDC has some great suggestions about how to share facts about COVID-19 in ways that your child can understand, teaching them how to cope with stress and more. In these challenging times, I am incredibly moved by the stories of the many ways that Gresham residents are helping one another, checking in on their neighbors, donating food, serving lunches to our kids, and rallying support for our local businesses. I am so proud to be your mayor. Thank you. Thank you for your sacrifice, your patience, and for helping one another. Keep rising to this challenge to slow the spread and keep one another safe. We will get through this together, and I will continue to keep you posted as I know more. God bless.